Lord, we say thank you for this blessed evening. Lord, we love you. And we know, Lord, that we are here tonight only by your grace. Lord, we pray tonight that you would stand with your servant, stand in your servant, and allow your servant to speak only that which you want said on tonight. Pray, Lord, that your people's hearts are ready to receive your word. And it's my prayer, dear God, that you get the glory out of it all. We love you, Lord, and we know we cannot make it without you. We need you, Jesus. So in the mighty name of Jesus, we do pray, thank you, and ask it all. And all God's people said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you will, turn your Bibles to Matthew chapter number 6. Amen. Matthew chapter number 6. Take a look at one verse, and my prayer is that it will encourage us as we go into the new year, and that it be a theme scripture for our year, personally. Now you can say, well, Rev, I got another scripture, that's fine, but I do believe it's a scripture that we all could use, and it's a scripture that we can commit to memory and allow us to act and move in the way God wants us to move. Matthew chapter 6, verse number 33. Matthew chapter 6, verse number 33. Word of God says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. My. The grass withers, the flower thereof fadeth away, but the word of our God shall stand forever. For subject on tonight, God will provide. Amen. 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 See it on tonight. Amen. And praise the Lord. This particular scripture, we find Jesus talking in what we call the Sermon on the Mount. And in the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus, he shared a lot of principles, life principles. Really for us to really take heed to and live by. When you get a chance, study chapters 5 through 7 of Matthew. I promise you it'll bless your life. And it ministers to the saint to help them to understand what really God what expects of us, right? But when we take a look at Matthew 6 and 33, Christ is at the end of a passage, or at the end of the passage, or a section in his sermon where he's talking about worrying. Oh my God. He's talking about worrying. How many of us can say that 2022 has brought about some worry? Brought about some stress. I heard old preacher say, well, I remember coming up where we had more month at the end of our money than money at the end of the month. Right. So really, you know, Jesus is talking to them about, you know, provision. You know, having the things that you need. Right? And so he's talking to them about worry. And he's telling them, he says, don't worry about what you're going to eat, what you're going to wear. He used two illustrations. He talked about the birds of the air, and he talked about the lilies of the field. Now watch what Jesus tried to get them to understand. And this blew my mind. He said that God will take care of that bird. And that bird didn't do anything to sow or reap. He didn't do anything to provide for himself. He didn't do anything special. He just showed up. The lilies of the field, they lay there wherever they are, and God clothes them with the dew. He clothes them with what they need to grow.
Yes, yes, yes.
And Jesus said, if God would do that for them, watch what he says.
Yes, yes.
He says, are you not much better? said this one thing. And it's amazing as to really how simple the key to peace is. Every now and again, don't try to schedule a vacation. Watch me, come with me if you can. Don't try to go out of town. Right? Don't try to, you know, go here and go there. Go on your back porch. And just watch God at work. And what it'll do, it'll remind you that God will provide. That's all he's trying to give us. God will. He will provide. So what he says, he gets to the end of the passage and he says this. He says, now, this is what I want y'all to do. Now, to help y'all with the worry issue, just watch the birds and the lilies. And know that God got you. Then he came down and he says, now, this is what you need to do. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Watch, watch. And all these things shall be added unto you. So what he's telling me is this, in the place of your worry, seek God. And in the place of your worry, live right.
Amen.
Is that simple? Enough? Yes. I want to help somebody here today. Y'all better listen to me. It says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. You know what that lets me know? When it says kingdom of God, that means that I'm not the king. When it says, seek ye first the kingdom of God, you know what I said? That says you step down so God can show up. Right? Acknowledge the kingdom of God, and then guess what? We're in God's world. God is not in our world. Seek ye first what the kingdom of God. But watch, in his or somebody that was going through, or somebody that wasn't doing what they're supposed to do, and it gets your life right.
Amen.
You ever heard him say that? Yeah. You need to get your life right. You know what God showed me? Real simple. The key to some of us receiving some of the provision that we need in our life is just getting right with God. if he says, do his thing. and he's going to provide me with what I need, guess what? I'm going to be crazy enough to say, okay, Lord, I'm showing it. And I'm not telling you what I heard, I'm telling you what I know. God will provide. He's talking about the things and the necessities of life. That's it. The things we have need of. Sometimes we stress over the very things that God says, if you just trust me for, I'll provide it to you. Now mind you, now here's the thing. You know where we get from? Sometimes we don't like where it comes from. Can I help somebody put your cry aside and let God do what he does the way he does it, and you just thank God? Why?